Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, it's not an easy road. Until the day in which he was taken up, after that he through the Holy Ghost had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, ye have heard of me. Acts 1:2-4. Acts begins with a walk of obedience. About 120 people walked a Sabbath day's journey to the upper room in Jerusalem. They waited 7 to 10 days for the Holy Ghost, promised to those who obeyed God. Acts is a story of obedience. Jesus commanded, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judah and in Samaria and unto the utmost parts of the earth. This is exactly what they did. They spread the gospel throughout the known world. Most of this took place after the persecution hit the church and forced them to be scattered abroad. The believers in the New Testament church suffered because of their obedience to God. They did it joyfully, both the obeying and the suffering for the name. In Acts 5, Peter and John were in jail. What was the charge? Healing a lame man in the name of Jesus. During the night, an angel opened the doors of the jail and released them. Acts 5 verse 20 records, "Go, stand in the temple courts," he said, "and tell the people the full message of the new life." This command, when they obeyed, led to a cruel beating. Many think that obedience to God's commandments immediately brings blessings. At times, obeying God results in hardship and suffering. These men were determined to obey God regardless of the cost and rejoice at the opportunity to suffer for the name of Jesus. Let me tell you a story of two Sauls. They lived many years apart, but both had an experience with obedience. King Saul started out well, but ended up poorly. Through acts of disobedience, he lost everything. He was a leadership letdown. Ben Franklin once said, "He who cannot obey must not command." Saul of Tarshish, who is also called Paul, started out poorly but ended up well. Through an act of obedience, he gained the blessings of God. He was able to say, "I was not disobedient unto the heavenly vision." To understand that this is not an easy road, we need not to look far, but just to look at Paul's experience. In 2 Corinthians 11, Paul illustrates his experience on this not so easy road. He said, "Are you servants of Christ? I am more. I have worked much harder, been in prison more frequent, been flogged more severely, and been exposed to death again and again. 5 times I received from the Jews the 40 lashes, -1. 3 times was I beaten with rods. Once I was stoned. 3 times I was shipwrecked. I spent a night and a day in the open sea. I've been constantly on the move. I've been in the danger from the rivers, in danger from bandits, in danger from my own countrymen, in danger from Gentiles, in danger in the city, in danger in the country, in danger at sea, in danger from false brethren. I have labored and toiled and have often gone without sleep. I've known hunger and thirst and have often gone without food. I have been cold and naked. Besides everything else, I face daily pressure of my concern for all churches." He summed it up like this in Philippians 3 verse 10, "that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering, be made conformable unto his death." This may not be an easy road, but in the end, it will be worth it after all. The thought of the day: he who cannot obey must not command. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, waymaker, miracle walker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.